Today, we are going to discover the raw background widget from the Plus add-ons for Elementor. And with this widget, you can create sensational, premium and unique section backgrounds in WordPress using Elementor. And there's quite a few options to choose from, such as parallax, segment and canvas. But today, we are going to focus on the gallery type, with which you can easily add textures, particles, effects like fade in and fade out, and also some very professional transitions. Well, hello everyone, my name is Dave from the Plus Add-ons for Elementor, and today we are going to discover how to create raw gallery backgrounds with Elementor. Now, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel as we upload two new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also, please feel free to share with your Facebook community so that your friends can learn more about Elementor as well. Very good. So let's get started. Okay, so first, let's have a quick look at all the essential plugins for this project. So we need Elementor, which is our page builder. We also need the Plus add-ons for Elementor and the Plus add-ons for Elementor Pro, because the raw background widget is part of the Pro version. Also, if you want to design a professional looking website, we strongly recommend to install Nexter theme as well, which comes with specific extensions and loads of extra features as well. And now one more step is to make sure that our widget is activated. So we go to the Plus settings, Plus widgets. In the search box, look for raw. And there is raw background. As you can see, there's a toggle switch next to it. Just make sure that this one is switched on. Click save. After this, we need to clear the cache. We're going to performance. As you can see, purge all cache. Click on this. Okay. Save. And that's it. And now let's create our page. So for this, we're going to pages, add new. And let's give it a name. So maybe raw gallery background. So let's publish. And now we can edit with Elementor. And from here, we're going to create our section. So let's click on this. We select our structure. So maybe one column is sufficient. And let's increase the height slightly. So let's set this maybe to 550 pixels. So it's taking up most of our screen. And now we can insert our widget. So if we go back here and we look for raw. And right here, as you can see, we have the raw background from the Plus add-on. So we just drag and drop it on our page. Very good. And now we can discover and select all our different options. So the first set of options here is to select what type of layer you want to apply. As you can see, you can apply a solid color, in which case you can just select any color you want, just like this. You could select maybe a gradient color as well, so it goes from one color to the other. You can do the same with animated backgrounds, so several colors, and it will go from one to the other. As you can see, the colors are changing slightly, gradiently from one to the other, and it's absolutely great, isn't it? But today we are going to focus on one specific type of background, which is this one, the Creative Background Gallery. And now we can select the images that will be part of our background. So all you have to do is just to click on this, and let's go ahead and select a few. So you can either upload your own files or select from the media library. I'm just going to select from the media library right here. Okay, so I'm just going to select 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and maybe 7 different images. Okay, so just make sure that they are roughly all the same size, which will increase the result, obviously, in the front end. And then all you have to do is to click Insert Gallery. And now, as you can see, it is displaying all the different images one by one, very slowly. So we have a transition effect here that you can select at the moment is a fade effect. So it will slowly fade into a new image and the other one will fade away. But you can select blur, for instance, you know. So if I select blur now, as you can see, we have a blurry image and we'll slowly reveal the new one, which is very nice as well. Or you can select maybe burn. This is a different effect. Again, depending on the type of website that you have and the result that you want to project in the front end, obviously you might prefer one over the other. So as you can see, there's quite a few to select from, so feel free to choose any. I'm just gonna go ahead with blur at the moment, okay, for our demo here. And you can see underneath, we have the transition duration and also the slide delay time. So these are in milliseconds. So 1000 milliseconds is 1 second. So you can increase or reduce that. So let's say, for instance, if I wanted to change the slide delay time to 3000, okay, and then I can change the transition duration as well to 1 second, maybe just like this. There you go, 1000 milliseconds. As you can see, the images will display with the same effect, with the blur effect, but much faster as well. So again, you have full control over the outcome and how you want to display those images as well. And now underneath, we have the texture overlay. So basically, you can either display the image as it is, just very sharp and crisp, or you can add a texture overlay. So what are the different types? So let me show you a few here with style number one. So as you can see here, it's adding a lot of dots, like a grid, a dotted grid basically on top of the image. That looks very nice as well, you know. You can have style number two. This is also dots, but slightly thicker. Now with style number three, these are lines, there's vertical lines. And style number four is horizontal lines. So those two look more like an old television screen maybe, or something like that, you know. And then we have 6, 7, 8, and 9. So feel free to play around with these and select the one that you prefer. But basically the whole purpose of this is to add a little bit of interest to the image and also to give a different feel. So let's disable this for now and let's go to the next section here, the middle layer. So in regards to our options here, we're just going to cover one today, which is the canvas effects, and all the others like the multi-layer parallax and so on, we will cover this in a future video. So keep an eye out and don't forget to subscribe to our channel to make sure that you receive all the updates. Now we're just going to cover canvas effects, which is a very popular one, and for a very good reason actually. As you can see, this one is all dots going inwards, and you can select each and every color as well, you know. You can add as many as you want. You can select maybe style 2, 3, or 4. I think these 2, 3, and 4 are roughly the same. They're all particles like this. And as you can see, if I move the mouse around, they'll follow along. And you can change the color as well to add maybe a bit more contrast between the background and those particles. This is a very, very popular one, those particles. You have style number 7 maybe as well. These are circles like bubbles. And you can change again the color and the size, and even the shape. So it could be triangle, could be polygon, could be a star. And then let me show you style number 8 as well, which is a very unique one. You won't see that anywhere else, but with the plus add-ons, as you can see, these ones is like small bubbles, and those small bubbles are going upwards basically, like as if they were floating underwater. So again, this is very unique and specific to the plus add-ons, and this will add character to your background and also a unique feel to your images. Okay, very good. So let me disable this for now and let's go and discover our next section, the top layer. And what we'll be able to do is to add an overlay layer on top. Basically, this is why it's called a top layer. So what type of a layer can we add? We can add a solid color, a gradient color, or a texture image. So let's go ahead with the solid color for now. So let's select maybe a purplish like this, a pinkish color. And obviously we need to add a bit of transparency effect as well, so you can see through. There you go. And now, as you can see, now we have a forest here in the background, but with an overlay color on top, which add a bit of richness to the finished product. Now we also have the gradient color, which is the same principle. So we go from one color to the other. And again, initially the colors are fully opaque, so we can add a bit of transparency effect. So maybe 50%, just like this. And we do the same with the second color. And as you can see now, our images look totally different. That adds a bit of professionalism. And as you can see, you can play with any shades and colors to actually tweak this and add some richness to the finished product of your slider. And then finally, we have the extra option here. So basically you can enable this. If you see issues when you scroll up and down the page and you don't see the full image, you can enable this. So basically it will only reflect in the front end, not in the back end. So there you go, guys. This is how you can create raw gallery backgrounds using the plus add-ons for Elementor. Now we are open to your suggestions. If your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so then we can hear about your great ideas. And for this, simply go to roadmap.com. www.theplusaddons.com, and from there simply submit your suggestions. And we'd like to thank you in advance for your help and support. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, feel free to share it with your friends and your Facebook communities, and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.